where we will be learning, we will be listening to your music. Okay. So, I was talking about the atom. So, atom is the smallest. It is the smallest or tiniest particle which participate in any chemical reaction. So let's say I want to make CO2 in the lab. We can make the CO2 in the lab by burning carbon in the presence of oxygen. If we use carbon and burn it, then we will be getting CO2. So, what is this? This is carbon. And we know, let's say I am taking this dot. For example, this dot is composed of black ink. But if we see number of atoms in this heap or this ink particle, so we can say approximately there are 10 raised to the power 16 atoms of carbon. So the carbon atom, which look like this tiniest amount, which is actually composed of approximate 10 raised to the power 16 atom. So we can say atom is the tiniest thing in the world. But there are some other theory also. So there was one theory according to Dalton. Dalton's atomic theory. We didn't have that much of information in the beginning when we started learning chemistry. But as we move forward, there are so many theories. And the first theory which came into the chemistry was the Dalton's atomic theory. So the Dalton said 2-3 points about the atoms. So there is one point. According to him, it was the point of his theory. So according to him, atom is the smallest indivisible entity. I think you all recall it. But my question is it true? Is this point is true? Can we confirm it was true or not? So may I use some names? So Arshima, can you please confirm that point number one was correct or incorrect?
It's incorrect.
Yeah, good. You are good. It was halfly correct, or we can say it was incorrect. So let's say I have this atom, and according to Dalton, it is the smallest and indivisible entity. But we all know any atom is composed of a smaller particle. For example, this atom have some proton, some neutron, and some electron. So we can say an atom can be divided into further smaller entity, which are known as subatomic particles. So now we will write the correct version. Atom can be divided into smaller subatomic particle. Like we have information about the electron, we have information about the proton, and we have information about the neutron also. But is there only three particles, or there may be other particles also? So there are approximately 35 other particles also. And the latest one, which was discovered in 2012, was the Higgs boson particle. If you have heard about it, or someone called it God particle. So in the 2012, there have been a discovery which confirmed that there is a God particle or Higgs boson particle in every atom. Okay. Let's move on to the second point. The second point, it say, in any chemical reaction or in any chemical change, in any chemical reaction, amount or atom are conserved, which means atom can't be created nor be destroyed. So according to him, whenever any chemical reaction takes place, what happens? Let's say the last chemical reaction was C plus O2 give CO2. So here we can say we have carbon, we have oxygen, and even in the product we have carbon and we have oxygen. So we can say the number of atom in the left hand side should be number of atom in the right hand side. The atom present in the left hand side is carbon, so it should be also present in the product or right hand side. Same thing with the O2. We have oxygen on the left hand side, the oxygen should be on the right hand side also. But can we confirm, was it true, or if there is some exception or some point which do not follow this rule are available or not? Okay. So when we take an example of any nuclear reaction, nuclear chemical reaction. So in nuclear reaction, what happens? I have an atom of beryllium, which is reacted with alpha particle. Alpha particle, what is alpha particle? Hello. I cannot now so many names. Fika,
yes.
How are you, Fika? Fika, can you please confirm, is there, what is the meaning of alpha particle?
Can I answer?
Yeah, you can.
The alpha particle is a radiation that is one helium atom with no electrons.
Good. I think. Correct. 100% correct. You are good. So we have an element called helium, and it have two electrons and two protons. So what we do, when we remove two electrons, this will be converted into He2 positive. So this He2 positive is called alpha particle. So this alpha particle is nothing but He2 positive ion. Good. So now when we react or bombard beryllium atom with the alpha particle, we will be getting carbon which have mass 12, atomic number 6, and we have one more different particle which have no charge and mass as in 1. So this particle is called neutron. Good. Now let's move on to the third. According to Dalton, what happened? According to Dalton, two atoms of same element will have similar property and two element, so two atom of different element should have different property. Okay, so now we have to move fast forward. So let's say we have carbon atom, one of the atom it have mass 12, another atom we have mass 13, and there are carbon 14 also, which is used in the carbon dating. Similarly, we have nitrogen, which have mass number 14, which have one more atom, which have mass number 15. So, according to him, atom of similar and same element should have similar properties. But now we can see we have carbon, which belong to same element, but there is a different mass number here. So, what are these called? Isotopes. What are isotopes? These are the atoms having
atoms easily.
Yeah, yeah. These are the atoms which have same atomic number. They have same atomic number 6, 6, but they have different mass number. Same atomic number, different mass number. So these are also what? Isotopes. The second part, two atoms of different elements should have different properties. So we can say we have carbon and we have nitrogen. They both belong to different elements, but still their mass number are same. So these are called isobars. So what are isobars? These are atom having different atomic number but same mass number. Got it?
Yes.
Yes,
good. So now we have to talk about the structure of atom. So there have been some conclusion that atom is not the tiniest or smallest entity. It is composed of electron, proton, neutron, and 35 other particles. So how did we get information about these particles? We used cathode ray experiment for electron and proton. Cathode experiment. For this, we use what we use? Beryllium alpha particle reaction. And for all these other particles, we have a lab in the Switzerland known as CERN, CERN. So there is a tunnel of 5.3 kilometer radius. That is underground tunnel. So what they do? They have tunnel and they accelerate one atom from this side, another atom from this side, and they make they go round and round for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, depending upon their experiment. So after 2 years, 3 years motion, the particle gets enough amount of energy, kinetic energy. So when they are collided, there may be some big bang. And in that big bang, we get all these particles. So the latest one was Higgs boson particle in 2012. I think you have heard about it. So this is beyond our subject, or this is even beyond PhD, postdoc. So we will be taking up to the electron proton. So let's revise cathode experiment. How electron and proton was discovered? Let's recap it. So the meeting is going to be over in 2 to 3 minutes, so you have to rejoin it. So what is cathode ray experiment? We have this tube called discharge tube or cathode tube. And in this tube, we have one metal plate, another metal plate, but this metal plate have holes in it. And this metal plate is called perforated anode. And this is called cathode. Then what we do, we use some gas, let's take hydrogen gas. And we maintain very low pressure. So the pressure is approximate 10 to the power minus 2, 10 to the power minus 3 mm of Hg. It's a very low pressure. And we apply very high voltage. So that is approximately 10,000 to 20,000 volt. What happens when we apply this amount of voltage and at very low pressure? We know the atom is composed of electron, proton and neutron. So let's say this is an atom and there is an electron. So the electron will be knocked out. The electron will be knocked out by the electric field line coming out of this cathode metal plate. So let's say these are some atoms in which there is an electron, and when very high voltage are applied, so the electron can be knocked out by this ray. So the particle which coming out of this ray will be called cathode particle. So this came out here, this came out here, and similarly this particle came out here.
You know,
what happened? So we can say there are so many these electron or cathode ray particles. So these particles collectively, this particle moves from cathode to anode. So these are called what? These are called cathode particle. And later we called them electron. Got it? How did we confirm it? So there is ZnS coating beside the anode. So this ZnS coating show illumination when charged particle, when the charged particle extracted here. So there was